Device. Testing. Testing. Do I have audio? Do I have a chat? I got chat, but I can't see it. It's too tiny. That is Kitsu. I figured it was you. Like, nobody else knows that I'm streaming right now, so. Oh, I do not have background image. I could accidentally show something I shouldn't. Alright, let's see if I can get the docs. Chat. For some reason I cannot get the chat to actually dock into OBS, so it just floats, which ends up being annoying because it interferes. If I had two monitors running, then it wouldn't be an issue. I actually could set up a second monitor. Except I think the only other monitor I got that's working here is not working well. Chat is loading. And I am going to shut off Discord to save some resources. And I'm going to hog a bunch more resources. By trying to load Twitch. So I can get the link for my stream, and then I can post it to Slack. Oh, this is just running like crud. Type about 100 characters and then wait, and then they'll eventually show up. Oh, yeah. Just don't like it at all. Just please stand by. I know that we're probably locked up solid in OBS. Oh, my drop frames has not really changed. Come on, wait. That's all I want. Kill this page before it tries to load videos. Okay. Don't need to see my passwords either. We don't need to see this help. Don't need to see this Google document. Or that either. Okay. All right, let's give it about 5 minutes so that everything can settle, and we'll see if the frames, if things improve. Oh, wait, I was going to do this. Come on. I something into the chat, hit enter, looked up, nothing. Maybe if I wait a few seconds. There it comes up. Jeepers, cripes. Yes, it is definitely not happy with it. Is the audio choppy, or is it just the video that's choppy, or is it both? Kitsu. All right, we lost one camera already. It's having a fit because it thinks that the SIM card isn't in it. Yeah, I'm using old cell phones for IP cameras. We got a guy that's going to be donating some IP cameras, but for right now, this is a very scuffed way of doing things. And the newer laptop wants to restart. Not this one. The one that actually is in decent shape. Okay. as you can see from the screen, we've got a Prusa i3 that is running some blast gates. What film did we use? I believe it's some local stuff. I think it's PLA from Coex in Appleton, Wisconsin. Nothing really exciting. Not my preferred stuff, but one of the other makers at the Makerspace has a preference for it. And he likes to encourage shopping local. Going to hydrate, which no one can redeem because I'm not affiliated, but I'm going to hydrate anyway. James, did that answer your question? I'd ask that in chat, but it would take like 30 seconds for me to type it to actually have it show up on chat. Let's see if that one's phone is recording. No. Oh, what is my favorite thing that I've printed? As odd as that sounds, probably an SD card holder. Just because it didn't need supports, it printed right on the first try. It is very unobtrusive sitting on my desk at home, and it's where I keep all my SD cards for 3D printing and stuff. I haven't printed like a lot of cool things or a lot of really interesting things, mainly because I like to make things, so I end up designing my own stuff, and I don't like get real fancy with it. One of the future things that we're looking at doing is we're going to be printing a mostly printed CNC, which I'm sure you know about. We got a plasma cutter that we'd like to convert over to CNC, and I'd also like to do a full panel wood router as CNC, so that we could just take a sheet of plywood, stick it into CNC, and cut all the parts out of it in one go. But the other camera view is of our laser cutter. I don't even know if... Here, can I change that screen layout? Oh, yeah, let's put... should we have that come down one? Yeah, that's not too bad. I just finished doing some repairs on it. So now it doesn't give us a fault. It actually says... It says armed instead of fault when it's supposed to. I also did other additional testing, make sure it wasn't a bad sense or anything. It was just a loose wire. So we attached a wire, it worked. So anyway, I'm going to go set to laser to go burn an image of a waifu poster size. Oh. Will hopefully not explode. Is that camera angle still off?
Yeah, that's not right.
Oh, hold on a second. I think I know why. Well, let's see. Oh, that's what I got to reset. Come on, reload. There we go. No. Hey, the laser didn't beep yet, did it? No, it didn't beep yet. Oh, well, I am here. Come on, load. Probably should close that app on my laptop too and just use my phone for it. Yes, yes, notify, notify, notify. So what do we got? Okay, flickered, so that must be still updating. Hey, I heard a beep. There's nothing exciting to look at the laser yet, but once it does about 5 minutes worth of work, I'm going to go and shift the camera over. You can see the little cable chain and the laser moving back and forth. You can also see the 3D printer moving back and forth, correct? Drop frames has gone from 2% to 0.8% to 0.4%, so it must have just been an initial glitch or something. So, we'll close Slack out because I can use Slack on my phone. Oh yeah, I was going to do, oh, I got incomings. Guess not. Must have been old data. Oh yeah, who's going to do this? No, not turn off. Turn back on. Oh, Play Store. Oh, it's already installed on here. Okay. Alrighty, let's make another one. Don't listen to what I'm saying out loud. Doesn't matter. You'd have to be at this makerspace to do that. Why can I not open the camera? Let's restart it. Well, that's interesting. It's installed on my phone, but it does not have the icon set up for it. Code reader, Wi-Fi analyzer, this cup of the clock. Okay, how do I turn you off? Oh, that's right, I gotta go all actions. Stop. Okay. Let's try it again. You're still not seeing the video. You're still not seeing the camera. Might have to reinstall this. Before we do that, go see what the laser's doing.
This might get blurry. Section up. Really should have a tripod right here. Okay.
See a lot of gantry action going on. You like that, don't you? Okay. Let's do this. So we'll install and we'll reinstall. And it's still not working. Okay, so why is it not built? Okay. Microsoft Store just got updated. Check it out. How about new? Not connect all network drives. Of course not. We're not at work. Okay. All right. So we'll splash it around here. What's going on? Microphone picking up the sounds of the lasers, humming and groaning. No, we do not want to start Microsoft Teams. Let's try to start at the beginning. Is it flickering? The video? Oh yeah, it is. That is a really old, crappy cell phone. It is BudBob's old cell phone. So yeah, it might be not long for this world. I suppose I could make myself like a Amazon wish list and put IP cameras on it. Yeah, that is getting worse, isn't it?
How in the world am I going to type that in?
Why, what's my chat text say? You mean the chat that shows up on... Oh! Because it's dark text against a dark screen? Yeah, but I can actually... I'll be able to see it on here, right?
that's up here as well.
Mute! Don't worry, mute. Don't understand the meaning of you, do you? Oh, wow, that is bad. I gotta go to the stream elements to fix that. I heard a female voice. Oh, geez, it's that far delayed. Let's try doing this. I'm going to switch streams. I'm going to switch overlays for a second. Encoding overloaded. Concerns turning down video settings or using a faster encoding. Don't want it out of the top. It's supposed to be a background. Moved it back. Bam! There, now you can see chat. Well, I'm talking about all sorts of things. You would dock so you're not in my way. Okay. Let's do. Which way is this? That looks good. It's this way I want to change. Okay. Use the Alt key. It's doing it while streaming. Come on, work right. What's going on in the filament printer? in the wood shop, we got a bunch of tubing that's used for dust collection. And we are, another geek is 3D printing some different types of solutions there. Now we don't have some of the white border. Probably take and get rid of that wood on the bottom. You don't need to see the wood frame. Oh, wrong button. Rug lover, Kronk! Oh. Hold still, you little stud. Just behave. Can I now play with stuff? Yeah, I was hoping I'd get this third cell phone to work with the webcam so you can see the video game machine we got here, too. It is not having any fun with it. That's like 5 seconds delay, it's not a laser. Wait, a laser printer is a thing that uses paper. Are you talking about the laser cutter, laser engraver? Now I see why streamers have such a hard time answering chat space. What you guys see is about 10 seconds behind what I'm seeing. anyway, what? The Zappy Zappy Image Maker. What does it do? Most of the cutting. But maybe a little. Oh, it does plenty of cutting. Really close. Come on. There you go. A little keychain for a local band, which I think is called Toast, which is why it's in the shape of toast. That was cut out from a big joke. You want to see something really pretty? See if we can get a good focus on this. Come on. Yeah. Frame rate on that just sucks balls. I'll try to do it in front of the laser cam, or the laser cutter cam. That's probably got better resolution.
Of course, it's got lousier lighting. I'll go do it over at the printer cam.
Hey, I haven't hydrated lately. I should do that. Where's my water bottle? Midas Tech Tips, ltt.store.com. Wait a minute. He's not paying me for this. Regardless, it actually works well. Fill it full of ice, put water in it, and the ice won't melt for like about 3 days. But you know, if you drink the water and then you add more water, that'll end up melting it. Yeah, that is a pretty design. He's doing some larger stuff now. I guess he got some custom commission worker stuff. He's making money. Yeah, these, he was selling at the local music festival for like $25 a piece. Just think that over for a bit while I wait for stream to catch up so they can comment. Yeah, this was all laser cut. Oh, that's a pretty ship on the back. So I'm showing it to the crappy camera. What I could do is like Quinn over at Bloody Hacks does. She's got stickers that say hashtag not sponsored. She puts that over all the brand names of all her equipment. And I believe she's actually had to remove some because she actually got sponsors. Bonnie Hacks over on YouTube, she does metal machining. Highly recommend talking to her. Her, I will give free advertising. Oh, let's see. No comments about me streaming at the Makerspace. Thank you for fixing the laser cutter, but that's about it. Okay. Holy smokes, it's already 5 p.m. 3 p.m. for other people. But I should get something to eat. I did bring food. Should I eat here? What else do I gotta do? Oh, I gotta do some design work for... We're making some giveaway items. Just little keychains. And we're not charging $25 a piece for them. And the future president of the Makerspace says, you know, I've been seeing the ones that you've been demoing out. And I was thinking, maybe if you could put the words Appleton Makerspace on the back. And then, you know, then when we do the tours and stuff, we do their names. And then they'll have a little keepsake that also ends up being advertising for the Appleton Makerspace. And I says, that's not a bad idea. Let me think it over. So, that was one of the things I was going to play around with. Terry, other reason? Oh, let's do. I will do another shot of the laser cutter etching into my waifu, and we'll see what the progress is on that. And then I think I'm going to end the stream.
This camera, it looks awfully dark. Looks a lot better on the stream monitor, though. But look at that thigh high with the little teddy bear pattern line.
That is going to get Bloody D so cringed out. Some fan art that someone did for her that posted on her Discord. I went and I stole it. And I'll give credit for it. I see that there's a little copyright credit thingy on it. But yeah, figure that's going to be really cringe. Small Apple logo. Oh, for Appleton. No, we don't have any apples here, so I don't know why. I don't even know why Appleton's called Appleton. But what I could do is I could chop up parts of the Makerspace logo. Oh, I should add that in, but I can't add it to this. It's not on this laptop. When I got elected to the board, I got access to some of the camera-ready art, including a bunch of logo stuff. It depends on the grades. The thing is that, and you can talk with Mud Mom about this as we was looking at it, and like when you're doing laser engraving of colored items, because I think that's the one that early got screwed up. When you're doing laser engraving of colored items, the colors don't really transfer well, and Bud Mom figured it out. What you need to do is you need to look at it, I think, in like a black and white mode, or what did she say? Like an infrared mode? And that helps show what the contrasts are. She had some issues with some of her art that didn't look right, She switched it over to that, then she was able to see that the contrast wasn't right. She fixed it and made it look a lot better. So, well, I think that's all I'm going to talk about now. I'm going to go stop streaming. I'm going to get something for supper. And then I'm going to go play with some design work. Probably using Inkscape. Oh, yes. To round this out, this is Baker Tater at the Appleton Bakerspace. In Appleton, Wisconsin, we have open house on Thursday evenings. You can check us out at appletonbakerspace.org. So, that's all I got to say. I will talk to you later, Kitsu. So, bye-bye, everyone. Oh, wait, I got like... I need to switch things. Come on, move.